Tradition, success, and leadership take years to groom. They begin with an individual's choice. Every team is forged from varying backgrounds, but one constant remains, the head coach.
I wanted to go to school right away. I didn't want to wait till the summertime, till May. I wanted to go second semester in January. So Ball State came out and recruited me. I took my visit here. It was kind of weird when I first got here. It was during Christmas breaks. And none of the students was here. And I actually got to actually gel with the team. I felt like family and I felt like home.
Well, it was a nice school and good environment, nice atmosphere. It was always a good thing I thought about it.
Main reason I chose Ball State is probably because of the coaching staff. Coach Taylor's a great guy. He has a great idea of the game.
He's just a down-to-earth guy. On the court, he'll tell you what you're doing wrong. He'll help you out. But off the court, you can talk to him just about anything, and he'll make you laugh. You can, you know, y'all can have just a regular conversation, and I really appreciate that.
I'm matured as a man under Coach Taylor. He put up a lot of things, and he stuck by me no matter what, even through the tough times we had. So I think that helped me mature on the court.
The journey begins each summer when individuals become teammates.
That's when your teammates come in. We understand we got to get better. So we stay in the gym. In the summertime, we get designated our wait time for each other as a team. No coaches allowed, just the team coming in, you know, to play pickup. I mean, just the gel with the new players and the old players, just to catch a bit of a feel.
Head coach Billy Taylor offered a challenge to the team, 10,000 shots in the offseason.
They came in and they talked about it, and they wanted to set some specific goals in terms of what they could accomplish in shooting. Pierre and Jared, they kept some sheets, and they kept their stats, they kept their numbers, and they really were very diligent in doing it, you know, consistently throughout the summer.
Well, pretty much the 10,000 shots that I got up this summer, it was in like five different spots on the floor. And everything took place in Worthing Arena. The coach told us, like, well, we need some type of competition. You know, what you guys gonna do? Who's gonna get 10,000 first? And I think that Jared beat me to it first, but I still got it, you know? So that's the only thing that matters, you know?
After months of off-season preparation, the anticipation and excitement turns to the new season. But before the wins and losses, hours of practice build hopes and dreams of a championship.
This time of year is just a lot of fun for us as a basketball program. Our guys are playing with great energy right now and really a lot of passion out on the floor. So it's been a lot of fun to see our guys getting out there and competing.
I think the biggest improvement is our experience. We have five guys returning that started majority of the games.
I think we got a lot of good talent coming in. We got a lot of depth in our lineup. And I think the new players will bring a lot to the table and really contribute this year.
The guys, we all blend together really well. You know, the freshmen coming in, we all get along. And then we all get along with the upperclassmen as well, too. So right now we have a lot of good chemistry.
We can turn it on and off. That's one thing about this team. We laugh and joke, but once the whistle blows, we're all serious. If you ever see us in practice, I mean, we're right at each other. You might think we hate each other. But I think that helps. You need chemistry on and off the court, the gel, the championship team, and that's what we want to be.
Yeah, I think it just has a lot to do with us. You know, we're always, you know, hanging out, always together after, like, in the locker rooms, you know, just talking, you know, watching the games. NBA games are starting now. So I think just being around each other, you know, is going to help us come together.
As the season starts, the challenges continue. Physically, emotionally, and academically, each player must balance their endurance.
They know if they need anything, whether it need help with homework or even social issues, they already know. Like I said, we're a family, so we do for each other.
Very proud of our student athletes, our players, for the way they've committed to us and really found a way to continue to work at it with relentless effort, great attitudes, and the results has been successful.
You know, as long as you have a schedule set out, and you plan everything ahead of time, you can do a pretty good job at it.
So. A lot of people understand it's hard work being a student athlete. It look all glamorous on the outside, you know, because, you know, free ride and things like that, but it's like a job, and that's why I tell people all the time, it's like a job.
The season started well for the experienced team, with big wins over Eastern Illinois and Indiana State.
Momentum towards the basket, but missed it, and here comes Malik Perry, bang! 2-0 at home, and we'll head to Butler to continue the success on Saturday.
The first test for the team came at nationally ranked Butler.
I'm actually looking forward to playing at Butler this year. My freshman year, I was hurt and was unable to play there, and, you know, just playing in Hinkle is, you know, an experience.
The Cardinals came out strong, hanging with the Butler Bulldogs for the first 5 minutes of the game. But from there on out, the Cardinals just couldn't get it going. Their four leading scorers on the season didn't even hit double digits in this game.
We got to find a way to have some more resiliency on defense to lock in and get a stop. And then, again, find a way to work together offensively to get a basket to stop those runs.
The team quickly turned its early season disappointment into success, winning 10 of its next 11 games. The team also opened conference play undefeated through 5 games. The season continued to seesaw with a season-long 4-game losing streak to end the month of January, but morale stayed positive.
We just look back at kind of the recent history. Look at the week that we went to Alaska. Lost 3 games in 5 days during that period. We came back from that. We won 10 of our next 11 games. So, you know, we're really positive right now. We're in a good state of mind. We know what we need to do to get things turned around and get back on the winning track.
Every good team is going to hit a dry spell, but the great teams find a way to get over it. And we can set ourselves up to be a great team. We want to be a champion, so we just got to find a way to get over it. We want to win. We want to be champions, and this year I think it's our year. Even though with the losing and things of that sort, we got to understand that we got to take one game at a time and we'll be successful.
To end the season, lone senior Malik Perry reminisced and embraced his final days playing in Muncie. The team and fans honored Perry before the final game of the regular season.
I'm trying not to really think about it. I keep trying to spend as much time walking out the gym and practice as possible. I might be the last one just slowly walking out. I mean, just trying to enjoy everything. It's going to mean a lot from where the program started to how the change is just sort of being so great right now from winning 6 games to now 17, hopefully 18 and more counting on Saturday. So it's going to be a good feeling, man. It's a bittersweet. I understand it's my last time playing in front of the home fans who embraced me 4 years. The toughness, that's one thing I want to be remembered for as one of the toughest guys to ever play in this program. That's one thing I strive to be.
For senior night, there's a lot of emotion for that young man, but he played with great heart, great passion like we've always seen from Malik. Ball's loose and it's on the floor, he's going after it. He's going to block out, he's going to run the floor, he's going to do all the little things to help us win.
With the senior day win, the team claimed a first round bye in the conference tournament.
It's very big to get that bye in the first round of the tournament. Now you're looking at playing 3 games in 3 days as opposed to 4 games in 5 days. Again, it just shows the progress that we're making. 18 wins this season, 10 wins in the MAC. We've continued to get better and better every single year, and that's just the growth of our program.
At the Mid-American Conference Tournament in Cleveland, young players led the team to a thrilling comeback win in overtime against Ohio University. In the semifinals, Ball State faced Kent State. The Cardinals fought throughout with 22 points and 11 rebounds from all-tournament center Jared Jones. In the end, though, Ball State lost to Kent State, but Coach Taylor celebrated the success of the team.
You know, I'm exceptionally proud of this team. It's always hard when a season comes to an end, but I'm really proud of what these guys accomplished. For a lot of this tournament, you know, 4 of our top 8 guys were freshmen, and they were playing a lot of minutes. And there are a number of times where we had 4 freshmen on the floor, maybe with Jared or with Randy. So that's a strong statement about kind of where the program is. We still have a lot of youth, and we have some talent. You know, we'll look back and we'll have some more time for reflection about some wonderful things that we did this year.
Though the season ended without a championship, the Cardinals finished with the program's best season since 2002. Taylor had his first winning record as the head coach, and Perry saw the team grow more successful in each of his 4 years. The future looks bright for the young Cardinals, with everyone but Perry returning. For Perry, this may be the end of his college playing days, but he will always remain with the team in spirit and inspiration.
They understand that they need me, I'm there, and just like I need them, I'm there. Just like we still talk to Bradley Chisholm and Terrence Watson, Rob Dahl, Evan Knowles, no guys. I mean, it's a relationship. I mean, you understand, that's where you meet most of your best friends is in college. So, I mean, to keep that connection is huge for me, and I just want to keep that. And I told them, man, I mean, when I leave, I'm leaving for this year, but I'm always a Cardinal.